when it was first announced, I did a video on a little project called Wayback. It calls itself a Wayland-based X11 environment, which is not exactly an inaccurate description, but it might lead you to think it does something it doesn't actually do. A more accurate description is Wayback is an X11 compatibility layer which allows for running full X11 desktop environments using Wayland components. It is intended to eventually replace the classic Xorg server, thus reducing maintenance burden of X11 applications. Basically, there is going to come a point in the relatively near future, probably, I don't know, in the next couple of years, where mainstream distros, let's be honest, probably Fedora being the first one, are going to entirely drop Xorg. When the desktops they are shipping only support Wayland, there's going to be less of a reason to have Xorg around. Xorg is going to be around on Arch Linux, Gentoo. We'll see what happens with the new Phoenix server, but no matter what happens, you're not shifting the direction that things are going. Wayland is the direction things are going, but I do think there is value in keeping that X11 site around. And Wayback is one of those approaches to keep that support there, but try to make it more maintainable. There are a bunch of X11 environments which are not going anywhere anytime soon, in some cases, are probably never going to support Wayland, and there's a bunch of X11 window managers where you'd have to fundamentally rewrite them, and no one's even modified the code in, you know, 15 years, and there are people that have been running these environments for upwards of 30 years, which they're happy with what they're doing, and they're not going to make a change, and that's totally fine. I think you should keep running what you want to run. And this is just another way to keep things around. So basically what it is doing is taking the concept of a rootful X-Wayland window. So normally X-Wayland is run in a rootless mode, where there is no window manager, your Wayland compositor is doing the window management. In rootful, you actually run an X11 window manager and let it manage windows inside the X11 server, because X-Wayland is also an X11 server. Basically, if you then combine this with a stripped-down Wayland compositor, you could then have a Wayland compositor that you launch that opens up X-Wayland in a rootful mode, and then all of your X11 environment is just taking up your entire screen, and you don't really need to pay attention to the fact that you're on Wayland, because what you're interacting with is still at its core going to be X11. And whilst there's certainly a push to native Wayland applications, X-Wayland is not going anywhere anytime soon, and even if it does, Wayback, it can do its own thing and keep it around. And recently, Wayback had its 0.3 release. Now, when I did my original video, I didn't actually show Wayback running, and the main reason why I didn't do that is they didn't have documentation back then. They didn't actually explain how to make it run. So unless you read the code, you wouldn't be able to work out how to do it. So at the time, it wasn't very useful. Now it's gotten a little bit more useful. There are certainly problems. This is alpha software, this is not ready to be used, this is not replacing Xorg anytime soon, but it is usable to some extent. For the sake of making things easy to capture, I will be launching this from the terminal on my Wayland environment nested inside of this. This is here for debugging and testing purposes, but isn't the way you would normally go and run it. If you actually wanted to use this to replace your X11 environment, to replace your Xorg server, you would go and launch it directly from your TTY like you would with something like StartX, or go and open it up from your display manager. If your goal instead is to have a nested X11 environment for, I don't know, whatever reason you might want to do so, instead of launching it from the TTY, X-Wayland Run is a much better tool for the job, and this is something a lot of people have messed around with. So, according to the manual, according to the docs, which are currently work in progress, here is how we should theoretically be able to use it. So there are three components of Wayback. The Wayback Compositor, this is the Wayland Compositor that is launching X-Wayland. X Wayback, a stub X server that launches Wayback Compositor and X Wayland, and Wayback Session, a StartX-like session launcher. This is so much like StartX, it actually goes and reads your XInit RC. With that in mind, this right here is my XInit RC. It is literally just a single line, exec awesome. That is awesome WM for anyone who doesn't go and use X11 window managers. So, what we can do is go Wayback dash session, and there we go. It's an X11 environment. Now, being a window manager, it's going to be very keyboard driven, and the keybinds I use on Niri are going to be the same keybinds I use on Awesome, so things are not going to be properly passed through. If you're running this directly from your TTY, all of your keybinds would work as you'd expect. And you're immediately seeing why Wayback is not the better option for doing nesting. I resized the window and it didn't resize the monitor that it thinks it has. Obviously, this wouldn't be a problem if you launched directly from your TTY because your monitor is going to be at the size it needs to be at. You could fix this by using XRander and setting the size properly, but again, Wayback is not intended for nesting. It is intended to be launched directly. Now, whilst Awesome WM does work, this is very, very, very alpha software, and let's go and try another window manager. So let's go, instead of Awesome, do i3. I don't know why this is happening, but it tries to launch it and then immediately crashes. There's something here that's causing that to happen. It says something about a permission issue, which shouldn't be happening. I don't know why this is happening, why it's breaking, but i3 for some reason isn't working on at least my system. And before anyone complains, oh, but what if it's something else? No, the command to launch it with XInit is i3, so I don't know why that is happening. Again, it might just be my system. Your mileage may vary, so alpha software. Wayback also claims you can just skip the XInit RC and launch it directly. So passing in the session name, and then it goes and opens. So let's try that. Unknown option. I don't know if they maybe changed something and then didn't update the documentation, or if it's not parsing options correctly. Either way, even though it claims this is something you should be able to do, it clearly doesn't work. This is very alpha software, and you should expect very alpha problems. So instead of doing that, let's go and have a look at the source code and see what we can find. So when it decides to open up, this right here is the Wayback repo. It stopped loading without things being loaded. Amazing. Okay, that is much better. I don't know why that happened. Here we have the Wayback session folder and then the Wayback session code. So right here is where the option parsing is being done. And there is this dash show config if we go and run that. So dash show config, if I can spell, I can't. It shows the version. This is the same thing as dash version. Why they're the same thing, I don't know why they're the same thing. But there's also this dash ses command. I'm actually doing this on another day because there was an update that partially fixed the problem. If we run this with no session set, it is going to now require that something is set. Previously, if you ran it like this, it would just immediately crash. So if I go and pass in awesome, it launches awesome. So that is working exactly like it should be. Again, if I do go and pass in i3 like before, it still crashes because failed to launch, permission denied. Did that say that before? I'm actually not sure. I'm still not sure why i3 is breaking, but clearly something is happening here. However, the documentation for Wayback is still out of date. If you try to run it with just awesome here, it is going to now complain the same thing. So that's not fixed. So this is just wrong. I'm not sure if this was right at some point in the past and just hasn't been updated. So yeah, if you're running the 0.3 tagged version, ses command doesn't work. If you're running the git version, then ses command works like it should. Now, once these issues have been ironed out with Wayback, that doesn't mean the application is in a perfect state to replace Xorg. There are still quite notable limitations, as mentioned in the FAQ. Can I use multiple monitors or manage my monitor with Wayback? No, but this is part of the roadmap. So for DPMS support, this is for doing your monitor management, putting the monitor to sleep, things like that. That is not currently working in Wayback. And then multi-monitor support, this is more of a complicated problem because X11 doesn't actually support multiple monitors. This is like a hack to make it seem like you have multiple monitors, but X Wayland was never intended for doing something like this. X Wayland is for taking an application like my terminal and then running it inside of my Wayland compositor. When we want to run a full X11 environment with multiple monitors and all this good stuff, you then have to have some way to glue multiple monitors together across multiple X-Wayland instances, because X-Wayland doesn't support, you know, connecting to multiple monitors. This can be done through a variety of ways, things like an X11 VNC approach to simulate multi-monitor support. This might come with some level of input delay, which is not great. Possibly there's some other synchronization method that could be done. Maybe you could have some additional thing on top of it that sort of wraps the multiple X Wayland servers and then treats it as if it's like a singular thing for the sake of X Rand or an X Inorama. There's a bunch of different approaches that could be taken here, all of which are going to require some changes to X Wayland and probably some new Wayland protocols to make happen. Now, because they would be private protocols, that doesn't mean 7 years of debating the protocol in the Wayland repo, so at least there's that. Basically, all of it comes back to the fact that whilst most of these pieces are in place to make this happen, none of them are really intended for running a full X11 environment, so it's just a matter of adding those additional pieces in to make it truly a proper Xorg replacement. Right now, it might be kind of hard to see the vision because a lot of the pieces just frankly aren't there, but basically the goal is to take launching an X11 session and make that something that remains possible long into the future after distros just completely get rid of Xorg and nobody really wants to compile Xorg themselves. The idea is to make it as easy to use as launching something with StartX, launching an environment using Display Manager, and just make it kind of transparent to the user, and doing so with an approach that is going to benefit from improvements made to Wayland long into the future, isn't tied to some crusty old code base that, yes, even if there is a fork like Xlibre, Xlibre has a lot of legacy baggage that nobody really uses anymore because there's a lot of Xorg stuff that it supports that isn't even in modern hardware and hasn't been in hardware for the past 20 plus years. This is a new, simple, modern approach to keeping the environments that people are actually using still working. It's not trying to replace Xorg on your 30-year-old hardware. It's trying to keep X11 environments working on modern hardware into the future, on modern systems, on modern distros. X11 isn't going anywhere anytime soon. It may not be the main thing that people use, but considering there is still COBOL code in production, look, X11 is certainly not going away. If there are still people that argue that systemd is bad and they don't want to use systemd, what do you think is going to happen with X11? So whilst it might be a bit rough still, do check out Wayback, give it a shot, see what it's like, and if you like it, use it. If you don't, well, don't, and come back to it later. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video, let me know your thoughts down below, go subscribe as well, and if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon subscribers, Deli Bearpay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and give me a way back. What is this?